this candle that this water makes the best teas.
Oh, it's no such thing, Miss Bitcher.
Gentlemen of the Medical Society of New York, the singular case of Miss Rachel Baker has excited the wonder and admiration of many. She is revered by some as a divinely inspired. She is derided by skeptics as a vile imposter, and those who consider her behavior as symptoms of a disease.
She left the company of the party. After 20 minutes, we were taken to her bed chamber. She lay in bed with great care and decency, no part of her frame being visible but her head. But she uttered dreadful groans and appeared to be suffering acute pain.
Chester, Potemon! Vilakan, Labo! Which one of you are the married woman?
Who is the married woman?
Your friends have told me about you. They said that you have come here for some bowl, but we have no bowl here, or no evil. That we heard that you want to kill your husband.
The party are with us. Beside us, among us, bearing invisible witness to all that we do.
Yes, to help and guide us as we make our pilgrimage through the wilderness of this world.
I see nothing in that proposition that is incompatible with the tender and merciful nature of our religion.
Yes. And there are those departed beings who I have loved as I shall never again love on this earth, and those who have loved me as I shall never again be loved. If they should retain their blessed spheres of attachment on this earth, and if they take interest in the concerns of transient mortality, and if they're permitted to communicate with those whom they have loved on this earth, then I believe in the deep hour of the night and in the silence and solitude that I should welcome their visitation with the most solemn delight.